Welcome to Good Mythical More. Do the ugly versions of produce taste the same as the picture perfect versions? Let's find out.
But first, we're going to do who you talking about when we read a comment that's about one of us and we have to guess who it is. Subtonic says, I love how Blank spreads his arms to make himself look bigger when threatened. this has got to be you, bro.
Spread my arms?
You do a lot of arm spreading in general, I would think.
I think I do a lot of arms akimbo. Is this akimbo or is this akimbo? Akimbo.
That's akimbo.
I think I do a lot of this to look larger, but not like this. I think it's you.
I think I do a lot of putting my arms together to look smaller. So, okay. I think it's the other guy. You and you think it's me. Link.
You were
right. Spreads his arms to make himself look bigger when threatened.
Hey, I don't do that.
Yeah, that's what we're talking about. That's what we're talking about.
All right, so we're going to alternate being blindfolded, and we're going to feed each other a piece of produce. It could be the ugly version. You know how there's like not the picture-perfect, pristine versions of produce that actually are just as fine, but they just don't look as good to the eye, but they taste as good to the body.
And then they get sent to a place for misshapen foods.
Because people won't buy it.
And we've been to that place. And we've gotten the foods.
Now, we're not going to tell each other what these foods are, but guessing the right food gets you nothing except closer to guessing
so
whether
guessing
it's ugly
whether
or not.
Whether or not it's the ugly version or the ideal version.
Yeah.
You want to go first?
Sure, I'll go first.
Okay, all right. Bring in the food, the first food. Okay. Yeah, so I'm gonna feed this to you, okay? And you're gonna tell me if it's the misshapen,
if it's ugly or if it's picture perfect.
Okay, open your mouth.
How big?
Big as you can. And now I'll take a bite. Yep, bite down. There you go. You got it.
Come on. Why? I didn't want to go first.
Yeah, it just worked out that way.
It's a rotten apple.
Rotten apple.
Where's my...
Hold on, but is it misshapen or not?
Well, there was some information. Ah.
Can I say in defense of the crew, Rhett was supposed to go first. So this was not an intentional...
yeah, here I am. But yeah, I'll go first. Something about the way it was like... It was... I thought it was an eggplant.
Uh-huh.
So I'm going to say it is... it was misshapen.
All right. Unveil yourself. This is just a regular Roma tomato, right?
No, it's not. It's oblong.
Yeah, but
no, it's perfect.
That's the regular shape for it. Is it Roma?
Yeah.
Is it Roma?
That's nasty.
I had nothing to do with that. I mean, I didn't hesitate to feed it to you, but I had nothing to do with it.
There's nothing good about that taste. It's nasty.
Well, a large percentage of the world disagrees with you. Okay, all right. I'm ready.
Okay.
How big?
It's, what is that?
Okay, so he's got questions about it. So something must stick off of it in a weird way.
Bite down.
Oh. Okay. It's a carrot. Ooh.
Don't kill yourself now.
Okay, it's a carrot and it's misshapen. Because you wouldn't be wondering about no carrot. And I also felt a little squirrely thing on the right side of my lip.
Yeah, I gave you too much information. Open up.
Oh yeah.
It looks like it's a witch finger.
Look,
like a witch toe on the end of a witch finger.
You could frame me for a crime, though. Look, you got my bite marks. That's how the dentists of old used to do it. Bite into this carrot. I need to make you a set of teeth.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Now, but it tasted like a normal carrot.
It tasted just like a carrot.
The end of it and see. I don't know why it's so hairy.
It's just roots trying to make their way out into the world.
I thought you bit your own finger for a second.
It tastes just like a regular old carrot.
Tastes just as good, doesn't it? See?
When was the last time... You just took a carrot and ate it like a rabbit.
2 weeks ago. Probably at least once a month I'll do that.
I love doing that. I haven't done it in so long.
I like carrots. We'll get the whole intact carrot. And I'll just dip it in hummus and bite it. And dip it again in hummus and bite it. Dip it in hummus and bite it.
What about not dipping it? Just like I'm saying, rabbits don't have hummus. I'm saying it like a rabbit. He just takes it and he just, whole thing. You ever do that?
No, I always dip it in hummus and bite it. And I sing a song. You want to hear it?
Yeah, I've already
Dip it in hummus and bite it again. We have a collectible for 2021. First of the year, Mythical Society collectible. We have these signature series. We put out one a quarter. This is the one that's coming out next.
You have to be a third degree Mythical Society member to get these. That's what one of the awesome things about being
the thermos
third degree.
Isn't in it because the thermos is usually here.
It is an homage to our alternative snacks, alternative universe snacks. As you can see, we travel regularly throughout the snackiverse in our TARDIS-like portal machine.
Yes, here it is.
Which turns into a thermos, or is a thermos. Now this is how we rolled with our lunch back in the day when we were in elementary school.
It's got a back, it's got a front. If you want to be eligible, if you want to get this thing, you got to be a member of the Mythical Society monthly third degree by January 31st, or third degree quarterly annual plan by March 31st in order to qualify.
Only place you can get that. All right, next one. You're gonna be blindfolded for this. Let's bring it in. Okay. Now, you're gonna know what this is really easily.
Uh-huh.
Let's see if you can get any information about it.
Broccoli.
Ready? Now, let's see if you feel around on it. See what you can learn. I don't want to look at that. Oh, gosh. I don't even want to be touching it. Okay, what'd you learn?
There's no discernible taste difference. No, it's unambiguously broccoli.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to say, by the way that it hit my mouth, it seemed very rounded, like splendidly tree-like.
Hmm.
I'm going to say this is picture perfect.
Reveal? That's a picture-perfect piece of broccoli.
That's a thick thought.
I mean, this is like something. This is like the house that the Keebler elves lived in. Do you know about the
Keebler? I didn't want to try to swallow
that. The Keebler tree? Anybody else know about the Keebler tree?
Sure.
Look at that. That's like the tree of life in the middle of the Animal Kingdom in Disney World. They base it off of a piece of broccoli.
Yep, you're right. Mm-hmm. I remember reading that.
You can go inside there.
Picture-perfect. I mean,
where's my blindfold? There it is.
Broccoli goes all over the place. Is there unpicture perfect broccoli? It's all ugly.
I'm sure there's some bad broccoli out there if you look hard enough.
Bring it in.
How big?
Okay.
That big?
Let's see. I'm trying to figure out how to even. Okay. As big as you can. Look at me.
That didn't help.
Look at me. Big as you can.
Oh, I can smell it. Turn it. Oh. It's a bell pepper.
Is it funky or
is
not?
Is it green, yellow, orange, or red? It's green.
You're right about that.
And it felt smooth and perfect. But it felt like it might be longer than normal. But maybe it's longer than normal. I'm going to say that it's unnaturally shaped.
How did it taste?
Excellent. Really refreshing.
Okay. Take a look.
Oh, because that's a bad one.
Well, no, it's a good one, but it's got a big dent in the side.
I mean, I would buy that. Bell pepper is the shape of the bell pepper.
Yeah, just, who cares?
Doesn't matter.
But it's like it grew around another
post.
Or the
farmer's finger.
Yeah, the farmer's finger.
The farmer fell asleep and the pepper grew around it.
Rip Van Winkle.
Yeah.
But it tasted the same. That's the lesson that we're learning today.
And it tastes good. When was the last time you just bit into a bell pepper like that?
I haven't ever done this.
I mean, it feels like what we're doing right now, just taking a bell pepper and just eating it like an apple, is something that more people should do, but no one does that kind of thing. Like,
very satisfying crunch.
It's like, I could sit here and have a good time with that pepper.
Yeah, I'd like to dip it in hummus and bite it.
I mean, yeah, you can have your big pot of hummus. But I'm just talking about this, the purity of like a farmer just picking up his ripe, waking up and realizing that his finger has a pepper on it.
Growing around it.
And he takes it and he just bites it.
Oh, look at this. I've grown a pepper on my finger. Is it my turn?
Yes, it is. Bring it in, please. Oh, wow. This takes me back. Okay. Is that part of it? Okay. Oh, got it.
Multiple pieces, huh?
I'm going to let you know ahead of time.
Is it a Twix?
It's not a Twix, and it has been cut. There's a cross section on this.
Okay.
Okay?
Okay.
And I'm going to just kind of... You're probably going to have to apply a significant amount of force. But it'll be satisfying. I'm surprised more people don't do what you're doing right now.
Is that a radish? I'm tasting it, and I can't tell what it is.
My uncle, who was a farmer, had a whole farm full of these.
It has no taste.
I think because it's uncooked. I think you've never had this uncooked.
It's not bad, but it's also not a banana.
Is it sweet?
No. Is it supposed to be sweet?
Well, to be true to its name, it is.
Oh, is it a sweet potato?
Ding, 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 ding. But, oh, is it perfect?
Oh, yeah, I forgot. I can't believe this is a sweet potato. A sweet potato is, I mean, it was like biting into an unripe apple. And it doesn't taste bad. I don't really like sweet potatoes, but I like them raw.
Okay, you like them raw.
I like a raw sweet potato.
Is it good or bad? Looking.
I'd say it's ugly.
Okay. I think this is a fine sweet potato. I think all sweet potatoes are a little bit rough looking.
That is wild.
My Uncle Gibbs, man. He had a whole farm of those.
Your Uncle Gibbs?
Uncle Gibbs. Gibbs Patrick. Down in Omega, Georgia.
Have you ever eaten...
Gibbs Farms. You go through there. You've seen that. You've been down that road. And y'all people down there in Georgia.
Have you ever tasted a raw... Taste it. It's interesting. It's...
Yeah, me and my uncle used to fall asleep in the yam farm. And there'd be one that had like grown around his arm.
I mean...
He'd be like, taste it. Just taste it raw, Rhett.
I mean, it's like biting into a carrot. It's exactly like that. It's like a fat carrot. It's tasteless.
My Aunt Helen still lives down there on the farm.
Why doesn't anybody eat raw sweet potatoes? Does anybody? Is this a thing? Can you Google that?
Already done.
All right.
An article pops up that says why you should use raw sweet potato in smoothies.
Is that like poisonous or anything? Like acorns?
Mm-mm. They're high in vitamin A and C, fiber, potassium, and iron.
It is good, isn't it? I mean, it's got a great crunch to it.
Oh, it says that certain types of yams are only safe to eat when cooked, but yeah. Sweet potatoes can be eaten raw.
I was going to say, lots of vegetables, you got to cook out the poison.
Wow.
Oh, you but they do contain... Oxalates that can
obsolete.
Increase...
Oh, we're going to become obsolete.
The risk of kidney stones.
Oh, really?
It's like a fat carrot. Well, I'm not going to eat them every day.
Yeah, just every other day.
But listen, next time you get a sweet potato,
bust it open, eat it raw.
Eat it raw. I would chop it up and put it on a salad raw.
Yeah, well, I'm planning on it.
I'm going to do that now.
Yeah.
You know what? This is, I'm done for the day. This is all I needed. Do we have another one? Just one?
Just one? Okay, here we go. I'm going to get this one.
Three. Over. Well, pick your favorite one because, like I said, I'm done here.
Let's go round seven.
I don't have anything
round
else
seven.
Learn.
Round seven. Okay, here we go. All right. Was that the sound of it hitting the ground? Hitting the floor? Hitting the desk?
No.
That was just you? That was the sound of it?
I just can't get over it.
It tastes a little sweet, doesn't it?
No.
No, it's the sweet potato.
It's just, you're eating it just for the texture. That's the thing. Okay. All right. Open.
Fact that Stevie's kind of excited about this. Makes me a little worried. Y'all gonna make me bite an onion straight up, aren't you? That's what's about to happen.
Open wider.
What the hell is that?
There you go. Bite it.
What do I do now?
Bite it. You want me to? There you go. I'm glad you got this one because I don't like that.
A cucumber.
Ah! Or, maybe. Is it one of those ugly cucumbers or one of those nice, sleek, perfectly shaped cucumbers? Cannot get over this.
Well,
I'm gonna get kidney stones if I don't slow down.
There's nothing off about it. There was something a little bit weird on the end, like it was at a point, like it had been sharpened.
Okay.
Like the cucumber fell asleep inside of a pencil sharpener.
Yeah, it happens.
You know how that kind of thing happens.
You can grow a cucumber into a pencil sharpener, and as it grows longer, it starts to sharpen.
So that's what it's a weird one. That's what happened.
Answer.
Weird. I said weird. Oh, it's perfect.
Yep.
Man.
It was supposed to be not. I don't think it is.
Oh, is it because it's bent?
I don't know. I don't have that information.
There's nothing wrong with them bending a little bit.
I just see on my scoreboard, it says imperfect cucumber. And I was like, we got to go for the imperfect cucumber. I mean, am I wrong? I mean,
you prefer it to be like this. But a little bit.
I learned everything I needed to know here. It should have been over.
A little bit of bend. There's nothing wrong with it at all.
Remember that? Remember when we were here and it was like, I've learned enough.
Now, if it starts going sideways, you got
I've seen enough.
That's what you don't want.
Okay. Get the Mythical Snackiverse lunchbox and thermos collectibles set by joining the Mythical Society Third Degree Monthly by January 31st, or Third Degree Quarterly or Annual Plan by March 31st. MythicalSociety.com.